The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, 13th chapter, text number 14, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on October 7th, 1973, in Bombay, India.
Everywhere are his hands and legs, his eyes and faces, and he hears everything. In this way, the super soul is his.
So, we are now discussing Jiva, the object of knowledge. Previously discussed the process of knowledge, Amanittam, Adammittam, Ahimsa, Khanti, Ajavam, Achaj, Upasanam, 20 items have discussed. The chief is Mahichananna Yogena Bhakti Abhyaricharin. The chief of them is bhakti, maicha, ananna yogena, without any diversion. Ananna yogena, bhakti yoga. That is the chief point. Then other qualities of knowledge will develop automatically. Dasyasti bhakti bhagavati apinchana sarvai gunai tatta samasate isura. As soon as you become a pure devotee of the Lord, all the good qualities of the demigods, Sura, there are two classes of man, Sura and Asura. Sura means devotee, and Asura means non-devotee. The good qualities can be found in the Suras, Ahimsa, Amanittam, Adammittam, Ahimsa, Kanti, Ajamam. There are many instances that the devotees are all qualified. Just like Prahlad Maharaj, he was only 5 years old boy, and his father was always chastising him because his only fault was he was chanting Hare Krishna. So, the world is so made, full of demons, that simply for your fault of chanting Hare Krishna mantra, you will have so many enemies in your family. This is the position. Simply for this fault, that because we are chanting Hare Krishna mantra, we have got so many enemies. This is the world. Sura and Asura. Because the more Asuras, these never tolerate. The glorifying the Lord, they cannot tolerate. It is very difficult for them. So there are two classes of men, Suras and Asuras. Sura means Vishnu Bhakta Bhavet Deva. Sura means Devata, or the demigods. And Asura means Vishnu Bhakta Bhavet Deva Asurastad Viparajaya. And Asuras means just the opposite number of Vishnu Bhakta. They are Asuras. So, if you develop Krishna consciousness, if you develop love for Krishna, then automatically the qualities of the Asuras, of the demigods, will develop. You haven't got to endeavor separately for becoming qualified in good qualities, automatically. Dasyasti bhakti bhagavati apinchana sarvai gunai tatta samasate sura. Harava bhaktasya kuto mahadguna. But if one is not devotee, he cannot have any good quality. Why? No. Manorathena asato dhavato vahi. Because he is on the mental platform. Devotee means one who is acting on the spiritual platform. And non-devotee means those who are acting on the material platform. Either bodily platform are mental platforms. These are material platforms. Bodily platforms, they are called karmis. They are working for their personal benefit. Generally, everyone in the Bombay city, they are working very hard. But what is the aim? For their personal profit. That is called karmis. Either in this life, even those who are performing yogas for being elevated to the heavenly planet, that is also karma, karma kandiya, they are also karmis. Either for becoming happy in this life or becoming happy, happy nobody can become. It is illusion. But by sense gratification, we think that we are happy. That is the karmi life on the bodily platform. And the mental platform is little subtle. The philosophers, the poets, the scientists, like that. So both the bodily platform and mental platform, they are material. Because the body is also matter and mind is also matter. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhumi rapa analo vayu khana mano buddhi rivacha aparayam. Prithiti me bhinna asudha. This body is made of five elements, earth, water, fire, air, sky. And mind is their subtle body. Mind, intelligence and body. So both platforms are material platforms. Therefore it is said, Parama Bhaktasya, those who are devotees of the Lord, they are not acting on the mental or the gross material platform. They are not working on that platform. They are working on the spiritual platform. So, good qualities can be attained automatically when you work on spiritual platform. But if you work on material platform means the gross body and the mind, then good qualities cannot be attained. Harava bhaktasya kuto mahaduguna manorathena asato dhavato vahi. Therefore we find that educated persons, so-called educated, they are not educated. Because in the Bhagavad Gita it is said, the so-called educated persons are bereft of real knowledge. Maya aparitajnana. Aparitajnana. Why? Asuri bhavamasita. Because they have taken the position of becoming an atheist. No faith in God. They are asura. So any asura, maya aparitajnana. He may be M.A., Ph.D., from academic career, but his real knowledge is taken. Therefore, he is atheist. Actual knowledge is to know God. Therefore, Krishna is expressed. What is knowledge? Jnana. Because as soon as you become actually wise, then you become liberated. But if you are not liberated, that means your knowledge is imperfect. Your knowledge is imperfect. So, the Krishna says, Jnana. Jnana means Matvara Brahma. In the previous verse, it has been explained. Anadi Matvaram Brahma. Brahma means Brihatyat, Vrinhanatyat, Iti Brahma. Nothing is greater than Brahma. That is being explained. How is Brahma? What is the meaning of Brahma? Brahma means sarvata panipadam tat. Brahma has got his hands and legs everywhere. Just like I have got my hands and legs. This is limited. I have got my hands. Why I cannot stretch 5 feet? Only 3 feet. That is also very difficult. But the Brahman hand Sarvato. Sarvato, everywhere. Just like Krishna said that Patram Puslam Phalam Toyam Jome Bhaktya Prajachit. Now, Krishna says that either a little flower, a little fruit, or little leaf, anyone can collect these things, even if it is the poorest of the poor. Then he can also collect a little flower, a little fruit, little water, and offer Krishna. My dear Krishna, I wanted to offer you something, but I'm so poor, I have nothing to offer. I collected these three things as you have prescribed in the Bhagavad Gita. Patram Puspam Phalantoyam. Jome Bhakta Apagacchati. The real thing is bhakti. Krishna, he has appeared here in his form to accept your offering. Not that he is poor. So, Krishna comes here to accept your offering, but the demons want to break it. This is demon. He does not think that Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, has so kindly come here in Juhu and accepting our offering, but the demons will not tolerate it. No, Krishna cannot. This is called Asuri Bhavama Asura, Asu, Rakshas. Ravan, bring Ram's wife, Lakshmiji, Sita. This is Dhimani. You are the great devotee of Lord Shiva. But a demon, first class demon, Rakshas. Therefore it is said, Harava Bhakta Sukuto Mahatguna. Even though you are the devotee of Lord Shiva, because you are not a Vaishnava, therefore he has no good qualities. He had no good qualifications. Harava bhaktasya puto mahatulama. Manorathena asato dhavatulama. Manorathena, my mental plan. Ravan thought that I shall enjoy the Lakshmiji of Narayan. But that is not possible. You can think like that. So, everyone is after Lakshmiji. The Ravan's philosophy. The whole world is after material. Acquisition, Lakshmi, money is called Lakshmi. Everyone is after money. But nobody knows that money can be properly utilized when there is Narayan. Lakshmi can stay when there is Narayan. Lakshmi Narayan. He cannot keep Lakshmi alone without Narayan. That is not possible. Then he will be finished, just like Ravana. He wanted to keep Sita. Without Ram, therefore, you are finished with this whole family. That is awaiting. The whole world is awaiting that disaster. America has got atom bomb, and the Asasi has got atom bomb. As soon as there is another war, the whole world will be finished. So, this is the Agyan, Maya, Pritagyan, and they do not know that we cannot keep Lakshmi without Narayan. That is not possible. Lakshmi can be kept at home with Narayan. But she cannot leave Narayan. So if you want to fall, if you want to enjoy false Lakshmi, that is the point. Therefore, a person who is devoid of knowledge, who is not devotee, Krishna conscious, he has no value. Harava Bhaktasya Kutur Mahatuguna. He cannot have any good qualities. This is our test. We are not very learned, but we can test. Because we have got the testing tube. Just like a scientist tests chemically, analytically, test how pure one chemical is within the test tube. Similarly, we have got a test tube. What is that? That test tube is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Namana duskitinam murha prabodhante naradhama maya apritagyana asuri bhavamasrita. as soon as we see that one is not surrendered soul to Krishna, he is Maya or Vritagyana, then what is the category? The Duskriti, no, always sinful, must be. Because he is sinful, he cannot surrender to Krishna. Navan Duskriti, no, Mura, and another class, Mura, rascal, without any knowledge, he cannot also surrender to Krishna. Navan Duskriti, no, Mura, Naradhama, and the lowest of the mankind. Why lowest of the mankind? Because this human body, this man's body, not the dog's body, cat's body, but the man's body, that is meant for understanding Krishna, Adhata Brahma Jigyasa. That is not meant for spoiling like cats and dogs, jumping from here and there. So, therefore, he is not taking the opportunity of understanding Krishna. Therefore, Naradhama, Adhama, Adhama is the lowest. First class man utilizes his life for proper benefit. But one who cannot, they are called Kripuna also, miser. Just the infinity of God, millions of dollars. You don't use it, you keep it only in the bank or in the treasury to see, oh, I have got millions of dollars. But utilize it. That is intelligence. Utilize, make it millions to 10 times millions by doing it business or something like that. That is intelligence. Similarly, this body, this human form of body, athāta brahma jiggāsa, to understand Brahma, that Brahma is being explained, to understand how Brahma, sarvato paripādasya. Brahma means the greatest. The greatest means not limited. We are limited. Our hands and legs are limited. But Krishna's hands and legs are not limited. Sarvato paripādasya. Brahma means Krishna. You'll find in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna is addressed as Parabrahma, Paramdhāma, Pavitram Paramam Bhavam. When Arjuna understood Krishna, in the 10th chapter we'll find, he is addressing Krishna that you are Parabrahma. Brahma, all of us are Brahma, aham Brahmasmi. It is not very difficult to understand. I am not this body, matter, but I am spirit soul. Therefore, anyone can understand that he is Brahma. Spirit soul is Brahma, not the Parabrahma. Parabrahma is Krishna. We are Brahma, but part and parcel of the Brahma. Mami Vamsa Jivabhuta. We are part and parcel of the Parabrahma. Therefore we are Brahma. Therefore part and a particle of gold is also gold. A particle of the sea water is also sea water, salty sea water. That is oneness. So far the quality is concerned, that is oneness. A drop of sea water and the whole sea water, in quality they are one. Because the taste of a drop of sea water is also salty. Therefore you can understand the whole water is salt. So you can understand Parabrahma if you understand yourself. That is called self-realization. Simply the difference is Parabrahma is the greatest and you are the smallest. He is Vibhu, you are Anu. But Maya is so strong. Because we are qualitatively one, we are thinking we are the Supreme Brahma. That is another nonsense. Because I am salty, therefore I am the sea water. This is not very good logic. A part cannot be equal to the whole. So, here, jnana means, to understand the Parabrahma means, sarvato pani pada. Parabrahma has got pani, means hands and pada and legs, everywhere. How is it possible? And that is knowledge. That is knowledge. It is possible. Because we are part and parcel of Krishna. We have got our hands and legs. Therefore, Krishna has got his hands and legs everywhere. But our hands and legs are now engaged otherwise. It is not for Krishna. That is called illusion. Actually, the hands and legs belong to Krishna. My hand, it is not my hand, it is Krishna's hand. My leg, it is Krishna's leg. But in Maya, in illusion, it is covered, upadhi. My hand means it is Indian hand. My leg means it is Indian leg. My hand means American hand. My leg means American leg. No, it is neither American leg, neither Indian leg, neither Indian hand, not American hand. It is all Krishna's hands and legs. That you have to realize. That is real knowledge. That is Gyan. You have to understand that you are not the proprietor of these hands and legs. Krishna is the proprietor. Therefore, Krishna's another name is Rishikesha. Rishi means senses and Isha means the master. Rishikesha. Senaya rubhaya madde rathasthapaya mevachyu. Another place, Arjuna has addressed Krishna as Rishikesha. No, and this is Sanjaya said Rishikesha. So Krishna's another name is Rishikesha. So, Rishik means Indriya, senses, and Rishikesha means the master of the senses. We have got our hands and legs. We have got our mouth, we have got our tongue, we have everything, we have got, that's all right. But the real knowledge means to realize that these hands, legs, tongue, eyes, ears, everything belongs to Krishna. That is knowledge. Therefore, bhakti means to become liberated from the false understanding that this is my leg, my head. No, it is Krishna. Sarvapadhi vinimuktam tatparatena nirvana. When we become purified, purified means at the present moment we have got this false knowledge. This is my hand, this is my leg. When we become purified, we understand that this is Krishna's leg, Krishna's hand, Krishna's eyes. And that is what. Sarvapadhi vinimuktam tatparatena nirvana. Nirvana, this is liberation. So long we are materially attached. It is mola. Mola means dirty things. But when we are purified of the dirty thing, we can understand. Just like Arjuna. Arjuna was in the beginning thinking that my hand, my leg, it is meant for my family. Therefore he was hesitating to kill. But this hand belongs to my family, to my kinsmen, to my country, to my nation, to my society, how I can use these hands and legs against them? Krishna will not fight. This is ignorance. He did not know that his hands and legs belong to Krishna. And when he understood, after reading, after hearing Bhagavad Gita from Krishna, he understood, well, I was thinking the hands and legs belong to my family, to me. No, it belongs to Krishna. It must be used for Krishna. Then he decided, Krishna, karishyel tat vachanam tavo. Now you want me, because this is your hand, your leg. So you want to use these hands and legs for fighting, I must use it. This is knowledge. This is knowledge. Otherwise how? Of course, Krishna is all pervading. Still, we are also pattern, everything. All pervading means everything belongs to Krishna, everything Krishna's energy. That like the sun is all pervading. How it is all pervading? By the light and the heat. Light and heat is all pervading. Although sun is localized, sun is situated in one place, how it is all pervading? Because it is supplying the heat and light throughout the universe. Therefore it is all pervading. And what is the heat and light? the energy of the sun. Similarly, the original sun is Krishna, and he has got two energies, the material energy and the spiritual energy. Therefore, everything is Krishna. Parasya brahmana shakti, sarvedam makhilam jagat, sarvam khali idam brahma. That is realization. When you understand that everything belongs to Krishna, because everything is manifestation of Krishna's energies, just like this whole material world, what is this? This is only expansion of the energy of the sun, heat and light. Those who are scientists, they can understand physics, heat and light. Similarly, the whole creation, that is Krishna's energy, heat and light, material energy and spiritual energy. Bhumi rapa nalo vayu khanga mano buddhi vata. Vindami prakriti rastadha. Aparayam nitastu vidhi me prakriti para. Jiva bhuta mahabhava. Jai idam dharjati jagat. That is the superior energy, living entity. So you are living entity. We are superior energy of Krishna. But we have become inferior on account of this material covering. We have become inferior, but we are not inferior. We are superior energy. When we act for Krishna, then we are situated in our own position. That is called mukti. In Srimad Bhagavatam it is said, mukti means hitya annatha rupam sarupena avasthiti. That is mukti. Mukti does not mean that you have got now two hands and as soon as you become mukta you will have 3,000 hands. No, not that. Mukti means sarupena avasthiti. When we understand that I am utilizing hands and legs and eyes for my sense gratification, no, this is wrong. It should be utilized for Krishna's service. My hands should be engaged for Krishna's service. My hands should be engaged for cleansing this temple. My hands should be engaged for cooking Krishna's food. In this way, my hands should be utilized for writing for Krishna, glorifying Krishna. My legs should be used for going to the temple of Krishna. My eyes should be used for seeing beauty of Krishna. My ears should be used for hearing glories of Krishna. My tongue should be used for chanting Krishna's name. That is mukti. Mukti is not a very difficult thing. You can attain mukti in a second. Simply if you agree, as Krishna says, sarva dharma paritajya mam ekam saranam gari. Aham tva sarva papebhyo mokkhasyami. Then aham tva sarva papebhyo mokkhasyami. This is mukti, mokkhasyami. So Krishna is offering you this mukti. Mukti parisāna bhava virakti-annatrasya. Virakti-annatrasya. When you understand that these hands and legs belong to Krishna, so I am misusing them. So long I misuse them, I have used for my personal sense gratification or expanded sense gratification. This so-called socialism, nationalism, this isn't that. That is also sense gratification, but it is an expanded sense gratification. He has got his legs and hands, eyes, head, then how he becomes impersonal? Boy, where is this conception come from Bhagavad Gita? The rascal said that God is impersonal, no form. How it is possible if he has got hands and legs, heads and ears, how he has become formless? Tell me. He is there. How he becomes formless? He is not formless. But the difference is, his form is different from our form. Our hands and legs are limited, but he has got his hands and legs that is not limited, that is unlimited. That is the difference. When we say, when there is such thing as formless, formless means he hasn't got a form like us, which is limited. Sachida, Ishara, Parama, Krishna, Sachidananda, Vigraha, Anadi, Radhi, Govinda, Sarvakarna, Karna. He has got his form, he has got his hand. Just like Krishna said, patram pushpam phalam toyam jomin hatkata jacchati. Kadaham bhaktya puritam asnami. Now if you say Krishna is in the Goloka Vrindavan, far, far away from here, how he accepts? That is the answer is there. Sarvato Pani Pada, he has got hands. That is the Vedic injunction. Apani Pada Jamanat Grihita. The absolute Brahma has no hands and legs, but he can accept anything. He can walk everywhere. That's contradictory. Pashati Apakhu, he has no eyes, but he can see everything. This is the difference. He has got his form. That is spiritual form. That is not this material limited form. But he has got his form. One who does not understand his unlimited form, Brahma form, Sarvato, everywhere he can go, everywhere he can see, everywhere he can accept whatever you offer, everywhere he can walk. That is his form. But he is not formless. Therefore he is called omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent. These are the adjectives given to God. Omnipresent. He is present everywhere. That's a fact. Ishara sarva bhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati. He is sitting within your heart. He is seeing everything, what you are acting. Ishara sarva sarvastha chaham ririsannivishta matta srute jnanam apohanansa. This is knowledge. This is knowledge. Not that to make Krishna formless, he does not eat, he does not see, he does not walk, he has no hand, he has no head. That is not knowledge. That is ignorance, foolishness. Mura, avajananti mana mura, manasin tanumas, parambhava avajananta. Because he does not know the parambhava. This is parambhava. Krishna has form, but a form not like us. That is parambhava. He is present everywhere. He can accept anything, wherever you offer. That Krishna says, tadaham bhaktya upuritam asnami. Krishna says, I say. Who are you to say that Krishna does not accept? Krishna accepts, provided it is given his devotion. That is wanted. Tadaham bhaktya upuritam. Anyone bring something to offer Krishna with bhakti, Krishna is not hungry, but he accepts. He takes whole food stuff. He still remains full. Purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. These are the basic injunctions.
Thank you very much.